So a common question I'm asked is, what are the warning signs and symptoms of cervical cancer? And when thinking of cervical cancer, it's important to categorize that as pre-cancer or a precursor to cancer called cervical dysplasia and cervical cancer. Cervical cancer in and of itself, really the most common warning sign or symptom from that really is abnormal bleeding. Most importantly, or what you'll read in the textbook, is something called postcoital bleeding, which is unforeseen or abnormal vaginal bleeding after sexual intercourse. And that usually happens because of the cervical cancer cells are irritated during intercourse, and they're very friable and bleed easily when they're touched. So if a woman complains of abnormal bleeding after intercourse, they certainly should seek attention by their physician. Other warning signs that we see with cervical cancer are more indolent and insidious. And what I mean by that is they really don't have any symptoms related to the GYN organs. A lot of times when we see patients come in with advanced cervical cancer, which is when we really don't want to catch patients, we have symptoms that really have to do with the kidneys not working, or otherwise known as kidney failure. And that happens sometimes when the cervical cancer becomes so large that it will block the flow of urine from the kidney to the bladder and result in kidney failure. And those patients come in presenting with all kinds of symptoms of fatigue, nausea, etc., that really are symptoms related to the kidney failure, not necessarily to the cervix. So our goal really is to catch women and find cervical cancer in its early stages. And the early stage symptoms usually have to do with this entity of postcoital bleeding. Alarmingly, though, a lot of patients, when they develop early cervical cancer, like stage 1 and stage 2, have no symptoms, not even the abnormal bleeding. And so what we really try to do is catch cervical cancer before it exists. And that's where we go from a screening standpoint in hopes of preventing cervical cancer. And the most effective means of preventing cervical cancer is the pap smear. And that requires regular visits to the gynecologist or your family practitioner, etc. That's the most effective means of preventing cervical cancer. And the goal of the pap smear is really to catch what we call cervical dysplasia. And that is the precancer lesion that in time will progress to an invasive cervical cancer. And when we catch that cervical dysplasia at certain levels, we actually treat it and actually prevent its progression to cervical cancer. And that's really how gynecologists and GYN oncologists have helped so many women not develop cervical cancer, is by intervening in those precancerous or pre-malignant phases to prevent the development of cervical cancer.